Welcome to the Barbershop Harmony Society's Course Director Development Committee series of educational videos. These videos are designed to give you the tools to lead any group of singers with confidence. Follow the videos in order, do your homework, and you'll be surprised at how quickly you build your skills. Good luck, and remember to have fun. The first item we need to address when speaking of conducting technique is the director's home position. It's human nature to mimic our leaders, and when we're in front, we are the leaders. What they see is what we'll get, and we as leaders need to practice showing the proper stance and alignment. We need to fight the urge to mimic the singers in front of us. The director's home position is vitally important to our directing technique. No matter who the singers are, where the performance venue is, or what the song is, every instance of leading singers begins with the director's home position. The most important thing we do as leaders is get our singers started, and knowing our own personal home position and how to find it gracefully can make all the difference. It's best to practice this in a full-length mirror, and practice it so often it becomes automatic. When leading singers, there are plenty of things our mind needs to be focused on. Finding your director's home position shouldn't be one of them. Beginning with foot placement, what we're looking for is a stance that's well-balanced, energized, relaxed, and flexible. The exact foot placement will be different for different people. But in general, we want the feet slightly apart and one foot slightly in front of the other. Try standing with your feet completely together, and you'll find this creates tension in your legs, as well as not allowing you to move naturally. Try standing with your feet too far apart, and you'll find the same thing. If your feet are comfortably apart, but flat relative to the group, you don't have the ability to move toward the group or back away from them. I find that simply by walking in place and then swaying right, left, forward, and back, when I stop, my feet are in the proper position for good balance and mobility. Now we'll turn our attention to the upper body. Many directors bend at the waist, thinking this will create a feeling of excitement for the singers. In reality, all it does is model poor body alignment. Singers bent at the waist do not have the opportunity to take their best breath, and as a result, cannot create their most supported tone. There are lots of ways to teach proper upper body alignment. One way that works well for me is to raise my hands to the ceiling as though I were shouting hallelujah, lacing my fingers and resting my hands on the top of my head. Allow my shoulders to relax, and then allowing my arms to come down to my sides. This results in a raised yet relaxed upper body alignment, which also conveys pride and confidence. Next, we'll turn our attention to hand position. In the director's home position, our hands rest on the ictus table, which is an invisible table where we'll show the musical beat happening. The ictus table will be at different heights for different conductors, but in general, all we need to do once we have set the proper stance and alignment is to leave the elbows stationary and bring the hand up so the angle of the arm is about the same above and below. You can see that if we bring the hands up too high, the singers lose sight of the forearm. If we go even higher, we have to raise the elbows and shoulders, and this can project tension to our singers. What we're aiming for is an ictus table which resides in the wheelhouse, or the power center, between the lower ribs and the waist. Many directors have a high ictus table because they say, "The singers won't be able to see my hands way down there." But in practical terms, the 18 inches or so between the midsection and the shoulders really isn't going to make any significant difference to the sight line of a singer who's 18 feet away on the risers. If the singers have proper windows, then standing on the risers or when seated in chairs, they will be able to see the director from head to toe. Prove it to yourself by observing the person outstanding in front the next time you're on the risers. Finally, we turn our attention to the face. Once we have found our director's home position, the body should cease all motion and all energy should be sent to the face. Our faces should tell each and every singer how wonderful it is to be there and how appreciative we are that they are allowing us the privilege of leading them in song. Even if the mood of the song is somber, it's important we make this connection with the singers before we move into character. Your homework for this segment is to practice walking with confidence to a predetermined spot and find your director's home position quickly, smoothly, confidently, and consistently. Once you've arrived at your spot, it should take no longer than a slow count of three to set your stance, find your best upper body alignment, bring your hands to the ictus table, halt, and smile. We hope you've enjoyed this Course Director Development Committee educational video. Your feedback is welcome, so feel free to contact us anytime.